Good morning. Greetings from the Department of Orthopedics, King George's Medical University, Lucknow. The department is known for excellent teaching for both undergraduates and training of postgraduates. An example is the department having greater than 200 videos available globally on YouTube with more than 100,000 hits. On the patient care front, cost-effective, safe, and timely management, which is socio-culturally relevant, has to be instituted by defining standard operating procedures. Regular critical appraisal of medical literature and CMEs have to keep these decisions updated in the standard operating procedures and keep them evidence-based. Our regular fracture clinic is ample opportunity to do just this. On research, we are simply not good enough users and producers of research. However, in talking about ideas and innovations, but certainly not following them up, we are the top of the world. Yesterday, in the demonstration of minimally invasive spinal surgery, we at the dinner in Levana Hotel were trying to figure out how best to pull the hole accurately. That is to put a pedicle screw through the pedicle of the vertebra without endangering the spinal cord medially and nerve roots superior and inferior to it. Since the Honorable Vice Chancellor is primarily a radiologist and the question here is of visualizing the cylinder, which is the pedicle, on the image intensifier with its posterior and anterior end circles perfectly overlapping, and then being able to hold it through the center by a trocar parallel to the X-ray beams being used to visualize the pedicle. Thinking about the discussion in the dream yesterday night, an innovation came to my mind. If we can strap a 90-90 bend rod to the tube of the camera of the image intensifier, which connects the center of the X-ray tube to the center of the camera, and if the intensifier is perfectly aligned to the pedicle, then the rod can help us pull the hole accurately. There was a biomedical engineer with us, with the visiting surgeon's team, and we can successfully develop and market this guidance system. Our VC will tell us what we will name it in the memory of the 66th Foundation Day of the department. Totally revamping of old infrastructure to make it modern and relevant needs a detailed project report to be submitted, funded, and executed. The DPR has to include floor space, fixture, furniture, manpower, equipment, recurring and non-recurring budget needs, and SOPs for the newly created units in the department, besides what exists in the department itself. For what was promised in 2016, besides recognition of MCH Pediatric Orthopedics by the Medical Council of India, central government grants for sports medicine and spine center, I have to report that no further action has been taken to date on this promise of last year. We have a long list of recorded and unrecorded achievements over the last year, which I take on record in this report. They may kindly be taken to be read, as we believe in Sukhduk Saris Prasansa Gari, Jagat Sovat Saran Tumhari, Tumhai Chhaadgat Dusar Nahi, Tinke Hirdaye Basau Raghurai. I would certainly not like to verbally abuse and embarrass anybody specifically by praising them, but would like to say about them that all of them are highly accomplished, trained and devoted people, excellent human beings, working very hard in abysmal conditions for very long, with great patience and tolerance. And it is solely with their efforts and blessings of our gurus and elders that the department has so many firsts to it, its credit. The most recent being the recognition by the MCI of the MCH Pediatric Orthopedic course just day before yesterday. About you, I can say what Sir Winston Churchill said about the young fighter pilots in the Battle of Britain of World War II. Never in the history of human warfare against death and disease have so many owed so much to so few. Sir, our building, including theatres, are in a dilapidated state. Our manpower is rock bottom. Our faculty does not have sufficient number of theatres to cater to the long lists of patients they need to operate. Anesthesia department is grossly understaffed and unable to help us in doing the required number of surgeries. Our patients are not adequately safe given no 24-hour X-ray facilities, investigations, blood storage facilities, vehicles to transport personnel rapidly between the main campus and RALC, HDU. Kindly designate your registrar and CMS to help us on a war footing for these urgent needs. Within a given timeline, because otherwise, ka barsa jab krishi sukhane, samay beet punka pastane. My young faculty says we are grossly underworked. They fight overwork. Not even I am spared. They fight with me for more work. I say, give them more work without delay, or let them find work to enhance their skills wherever they can. Of course, the second alternative is unacceptable under existing rules. The rest of the report will be appropriately circulated, taken on record, and may be taken as read. Thank you for your kind attention. Good luck and goodbye.